number. It is not a plus, it is all into. You write even numbers twice on the numerator and write the sandwiching odd numbers. 4, 3 and 5, 6, 5 and 7, and you continue. This will give you 5 by 2. Another nice one, 5 minus 3 by 4 is 1 by 2 into 3 into 4, then 4 into 5 into 6, then 6 into 7 into 8, then 8 into 9 into 10, like that. So this is a very nice way to remember such formulas. And there are umpteen such formulas done by, you know, invented or discovered by mathematicians. They really find a good thought. Ramanujan, as I said, without having formal training, he rediscovered many of the mathematics. Like this is known as Bauer series, but he rediscovered that 2 by pi equal to this. So by rediscovering a mathematics, you don't get much credit. But what Ramanujan did in 1910 is absolutely astonishing. 1 by pi, he said this series. Summed over k equal to 0 to infinity. Here 4k factorial. K factorial to the power 4. This is 99 square. This is, I don't know. I mean, not many people will be able to figure out how one could arrive at such a series. But Ramanujan being Ramanujan, he wrote this series. And you see the beauty of this series. If you take even one term, you get pi correct to 8 decimal places. Wallis series, Leibniz series, 500 terms for 3 decimal place accuracy. This series, the first term itself is 8 decimal place accurate. And every term you add, you get 8 more decimal places of accuracy, which is fantastic. First term, 8 decimal places accuracy. Each term adds 8 more decimal places of accuracy. So this is really the basis. A slight variation of this is still the fastest algorithm for computing this fascinating universal constant and has been used to calculate more than a trillion decimal places. So pi, as I said, mathematicians are enchanted by it, but they use Ramanujan series to calculate it to trillion decimal places. Now it's typical of Ramanujan. In 1911, he posed the following problem for the readers of Indian Mathematical Journal. Because Ramanujan didn't have formal training, he had a book where only problems were given, which he could solve. And problems are always proved this equal to this. So to him, mathematics was left hand side and right hand side, they must be equal. So he said, I give you the right hand side, you continue forever. What is the left hand side? So no one could give the answer. And after 3 months, he gave the answer. Answer is simply 3. Now how this, you know, continued infinite radical gives you 3. The answer was obtained from a typical Ramanujan type identity. Ramanujan type identity means which is mesmerizing. Even highest level mathematicians spent months to figure out why that identity is correct. Or sometimes wrong. He said, I know this identity. 1 plus x is square root of 1 plus x, x plus 1, x plus 2. So previously, if you remember the problem, here there was 2, here there was 3, here there was 4. So he said, just put x equal to 2. So I get 3. So the answer is 3. The question is, how did he get this identity? So put x equal to 2, you get the answer. But how does one get the above identity? He got it from a more general form, which is even more scary. He said, fx equal to x plus n plus a is this, infinite radicals. Only he could imagine such a formula. But lesser mortals at least can verify whether this formula is correct or not. So what I tried, I just squared both sides. So we can verify. Don't think I am proving it. I am just verifying, yes, it is true. We can verify this result. Square both sides, you get fx squared equal to this plus this and then this, which is f of x plus n, because you have, instead of x, you have x plus n, x plus 2n, x plus 2n. So if you square it, fx squared is ax plus n plus a whole square into this, which is x into f of x plus n. So you take it to the left hand side, and then a squared minus b squared is a minus b into a plus b. So I write fx minus n plus a into fx plus n plus a is ax into this. I take x common, so I write a equal to this. So now you see, if I say this first term is equal to this first x, then I get this identity, fx equal to x plus n plus a, and then the second term will be automatically matching. So I have verified it. Equating the first term, I get fx equal to x plus n plus a, which I wanted to prove, and the second factor of both sides become the same. Fx plus n is this, a plus fx plus n is this. So f x plus n plus a is x plus 2n plus 2. Now you put a equal to 0 and n equal to 1 in this identity to get this. And then you put x equal to 2 to get the answer 3. So this is typical of Ramanujan's mathematics, and no one knows where does it start from. But to him, it was, of course, everything just flashed. Like Ramanujan was master of creating functions. He was famous for Mach theta functions, but those are mathematically very intricate. I will talk of a very simple function which most of us can follow. So he wrote a function y of x as this, 4 minus 3x square root of, this is, as you see, 4 minus 3x whole square, 16 plus 9x squared minus 2 into 4, 3x, that is 24, cube root, and then 4 minus 3x, this plus is changed to minus, and this. So this function he defined in the interval, in the domain, 0 less than equal to x less than equal to 1. So let's put x equal to 0. So what I get? X equal to 0. This is 25. This is 25. So 0. This is 0. X is 0. So 4 plus 16 square root is 4, which is 8. 8 to the power 1/3. And this is 4 minus 4. This doesn't contribute. So you get 2. And if you put x equal to 1, then you get 4 minus 3, that is 1. And this is 0. This is 0. So 1, and this is also 1, 1 plus 1, 2. So at both extremes, x equal to 0, y is 2, x equal to 1, y is 2. That is not surprising. That's nothing, you know, magical. But what is magical is that you put any value of x between 0 and 1, half, 0.3333, 0.43759, whatever value of x between 0 and 1, yx will turn out to be 2. It is a constant. But any value of x in this interval, y will be 2. Again, only Ramanujan could write such function, but lesser mortals can see that he is correct. Why he is correct? You cube both sides. As I said, y equal to 2, at x equal to 1, equal to 2, but you cube it. So y cube, this is cube, so you know, this and this cancels, so you get 8 minus 6x, and 3ab into a plus b. A into B, as I said, this is whole square, 4 minus 3x whole square, so you get x and x. And A plus B is y. So you get y cube is 8 minus 6x plus 3ab, which is x, and y. A plus B, which is y, 3xy. So you take 8 on that side, y cube minus 8 minus 3x, you can take common, y minus 2. So you factor y cube minus 8. Y minus 2 you can take common, you get y square plus 2y plus 4 minus 3. So if this is 0, one root is y equal to 2. It's as simple as that. But to imagine that function is altogether different cup of tea. To prove is much easier. The only real root is y equal to 2, because if you solve this quadratic equation in the interval 0 to 1, you will find that they will be complex. So this can be generalized. Instead of 4 minus plus 3x or 4 minus 3x, I can write a plus bx. And then I can get, just cubing the same way for integer solutions, a and b, if it's an integer, a equal to 4, then this will cancel, so b will be minus 3. That is the solution we use, 4 minus 3x. And next one, y will be equal to 4, if I put a equal to 32, the 2 cube. A by 4 will be 2 cube if A is 32, and then B will be minus 6. So we get integer values. Okay. Now we come to a problem which was posed to Ramanujan as a puzzle. In December 1914, when Professor Mahalanobis was also in Cambridge, one day he went, on Sunday morning, he went to Ramanujan's place, and to solve the following puzzle that appeared in the popular English magazine Stand. What is the? Mohanaju solved it. That's why he could give it to Ramanujan. So, puzzle is, there are 10 houses on the side of a street which are numbered sequentially starting from 1. The sum of the house numbers, because every house has a number, 1, 2, 3. So sum of the house numbers on the left of a particular house having the number M equals that of the houses lying on the right. And that puzzle set is given that N, the total number of houses, lies between 50 and 500. So that you get unique answer. The question is, determine the values of M and N. The total number of house and the number of that particular house. So if we draw a diagram, it will be easier to see. These are the houses which are numbered sequentially. 1, 2, 3, 4, M. Then M plus 1, M plus 2, N minus 1, N. What is the question of what is M and N, such that if I add from 1 to M minus 1 and M plus 1 to N, you get the same number. So, now the story goes like this. Ramanujan, while starting his vegetables on the gas fire, rattled out a continued fraction generating all the values of M. Mohanaju asked on a unique value by saying that N is between 50 and 500 so that you get a unique answer. But Ramanujan said no need for any restriction on the value of N. You can get all the possible infinite values of M and that of N. Then obviously Mohanaju was absolutely startled because he solved that unique problem mathematically. And here is a person while studying the vegetables, he can rattle out a continued fraction, giving all the infinite values of M. So Ramanujan asked, how did you do it? So he answered, immediately heard the problem, it was clear that the solution should obviously be a continued fraction. Obvious. Only to him. I then thought, which continued fraction? And the answer came to my mind. This is his method, which is absolutely inexplicable, and no mathematician, even the greatest mathematician, sometimes a difficulty in following it. So let's see what is the problem. I said 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to m minus 1 is sum m plus 1, m plus 2 up to n. So this is a very simple series to calculate. If you do it, you get this. And if you add this, you get this. So do a little bit of algebra. This equation comes to a very simple equation. M square into n plus 1 by 2. So it looks we are trying to solve two unknowns from one equation. But remember, there is a restriction, n and m both are positive integers. So we can solve it. Don't think it is, there is no need to, no one can solve it because two unknowns and one equation, but the restriction is n and m both are integers. So there will be solutions. Let's see how to solve it. So please remember this equation, m square into n plus 1 by 2. Actually, m square and n into n plus 1 by 2, you know, Pythagoreans, they didn't talk of numbers. They only talked of geometry. So they classified numbers by the picture that you can draw. This is n equal to 2 is you draw a triangle. N equal to 3, if you do 1, 3, the 6. And then if n equal to 4, 4 plus 3, 10. So these are numbers. You see, 10 is 4 into 5. 4 into 5 by 2 is 10. 3 into 4 by 2 is 6. 2 into 3 by 2 is 3. So these are called triangular numbers. N into n plus 1 by 2. Because with so many dots, you draw a triangle. And m equal to 2, you get m square. M equal to 3, you get 9. M equal to 4, you get 16. So square numbers are m square. So these are called square numbers. 4, 9, 16. And those 3, 4, 10, they are called triangular numbers. So Euler solved this problem in 1733. For what values of n, the triangular numbers are also square numbers. That means n into n plus 1 by 2 is m square. That is the equation he wanted to solve. So Euler solved this problem and gave the answer in finite solutions. N equal to 1, 8, 49, this, etc. square numbers corresponding to m equal to 1, 6. As you can see, 8 into 9 by 2. That is 72 by 2, that is 6 square. 36 is 6 square. Similarly, for 49, you will get 35. And 288, you will get 204. So the answer to the puzzle is m equal to 204, because there are more than 50 houses. Sorry, n is 2ak, because there are more than 50 houses and less than 500 houses, there is only one solution. Between 50 and 500, 288. So that is the answer Ramanujan was asked to give. But what he did, he gave all these values of n by a continued fraction. So let us see, let us solve this problem a little bit. It is not difficult to solve. N squared is n into n plus 1 by 2. So you multiply by 4. So you get this. Multiply by 8 and add 1. 8n squared plus 1. So here you get 4n squared plus 4n plus 1, which is 2n plus 1. Substitute this as p and q equal to 2n. So this equation is same as p squared minus 2 q squared equal to 1. That p and q are integers because n and a are integers. So one solution I can easily get p equal to 3 and q equal to 2. The 3 squared is 9 and q squared is 4 into 2, 8. So 9 minus 8 equal to 1. So I can easily get the lowest solution by inspection. P equal to 3 and q equal to 2 is a solution to this equation. If it is a solution, then I can generate all the infinite solutions as follows. P1 equal to 3, q1 equal to 2, as I said, if p1 equal to 3, then n is 1 and q1 equal to 2, then n is 1. The 1 and 1, there is only one house, so sum of the numbers on the left is 0, sum of the numbers on the right is also 0. So that is the first answer. And then, to get all other answers, I raise it to square, squaring both sides. 3 plus 2 root 2 is 1. If you square, you get this. So I get two more values of p and q. P is 17, q is 12. P is 17, q is 12, when n, p was 2 n plus 1, so n is 8, m is 6. So that is another answer. 8 and 6. If you q it, you will get this. You get one more answer. So this way, by raising it to different integer powers, you can go on getting solutions for n and m. Next solution will give you 288 and 204, if you raise it to one more power. This is a typical equation of the form p squared minus d q squared equal to 1. We had p squared minus 2 q squared equal to 1. If d has to be non-square now, d cannot be 4 or 9 or 16. Because then this will be also a square. And 2 contributes a 2 square defining by 1. It has only trivial solution p equal to 1, q equal to 0. There cannot be any other solution. So d has to be non-square positive. Such an equation, because Euler called it Pell's equation, every book calls it Pell's equation, that is wrong. Because much before Pell, Fermat also deals with the same equation. But you know, books are written from previous books. So if some, you know, very famous person makes a mistake, that mistake continues forever. Because everybody copies from Euler, and Euler called it Pell's equation, so everybody calls it Pell's equation. Actually, now Westerners accept this equation should be called Brahmagupta's equation. Because much before Fermat and Euler, Brahmagupta Siddhanta, about 650 AD, Brahmagupta solved this equation, p squared minus 92 q squared equal to 1. P squared minus dq squared, d is a non-square positive integer. And he solved it and then challenged that if anyone who can solve this equation within 1 year, I will call him a great mathematician. Why? Because here the lowest solution is that which you cannot find by inspection. If you remember p squared minus 2 q squared, I could immediately find p equal to 3 and q equal to 2, because very small number. But here the lowest solution is 1151 and q1 is 120. So by trial and error, you cannot find the smallest solution. You have to know the method. And Brahmagupta did. Actually, these equations are very notorious. Because you see, if d is 60, the lowest solution is this. D is 62, then the lowest solutions are these. But d is 61, then the lowest solutions are these. sorry, I think I was shouting enough so that people could hear me from the back. You see, that's D, 60 to 62, how the lowest solution is varying. So it is a notorious equation, and if D is this and this, then Q1 and Q1 I cannot write. It's astronomically large numbers. But now people have done it with computers, there is not much difficulty. So Ramanujan's solution to this is as follows. This was the equation, if you remember, n squared was n into n plus 1 by 2. So Ramanujan wanted to solve 2n squared into n plus 1. He got the first two values of m, namely 1 and 6. Because he said if there is only one house, then the sum total of the house numbers on my left and on my right both are 0. So m equal to 1 and n equal to 1, the first solution. Second solution also he got mentally. If there are 8 houses and the house number 6, then on the left I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you add, you get 15. And on the right you have 7 and 8. If you add, you get 15. So the second solution is 6 and 8. So the first two values of m is 1 and 6. Then he said that if you write this continued fraction, 1 by 6 minus 1 by 6 minus 1 by 6 and go on writing it, and you truncate it at any step, you get two solutions of m. If you truncate it at the first step, you get 1 by 6. So you get two solutions for m, 1 and 6. If you truncate it at the second step, 1 minus 6 by 1 by 6, so 35 by 6, 1 by 6 by 35, so you get two more solutions, 6 and 35. If you cut it after minus 1 by 6, then you get 35 by 204. So you get two more solutions, 35 and 204. That was the answer which Mohanadovich was looking for. So he had only one answer, 1 by that continued fraction, 1 by 6 minus 1 by 6 minus 1 by 6. This is sheer simple magic. Now the question is, why did the magic work? Magician can show the magic, but ultimately one has to figure out why did the magic work. This was an unknown continued fraction. So if you say that fraction is x, then this whole thing, because it continued, so I can write that also as x. So I get this. So I get this quadratic equation, x squared minus 6x plus 1 equal to 0. If you solve for x, you get 3 minus 2 root 2 and 3 plus 2 root 2, but since x is less than 1, so this is the solution. So 1 upon x is 3 plus 2 root 2, so this into this is 1. Now I think we remember this was the equation which we also started from. Then we raised it to different powers to get the infinite solution. So it is Ramanujan's genius. He could see this continued fraction is 3 minus 2 root 2. So I get all the solution at one stroke. This is that equation P which generated all the solutions. Now, I end this lecture with a happy collaboration between Hardy and Ramanujan, because Hardy was his collaborator and mentor who took him to Cambridge and really introduced Ramanujan to the entire world. Otherwise, Ramanujan would have been a forgotten, you know, scientist, because in India there was no one to appreciate or understand his work. In fact, when Ramanujan wrote his mathematics to lots of professors in UK, only Hardy replied, others didn't bother. Hardy said, because he didn't understand most of his expressions, but he said it must be correct, otherwise no one can have the imagination to write it if it is wrong. With that conviction, Hardy invited Ramanujan to Cambridge, and they did a lot of work together. And the most important famous work is partitioning of a number. What is partitioning? Suppose 4 is a number which I can write as 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 plus 2, 1 plus 3, 2 plus 2 and 4. So I can write 5 different ways. So partitioning function, as it's called, P4 is 5. So Ramanujan said, can I write a formula for Pn, where n is any number? That was the work. P10, as you see, is 42, and P50 is so large, because this will be astronomically large number as n increases. So any formula for Pn, for arbitrary n, that is the work which made Hardy and Ramanujan both Of course, here there is, as I said, happy collaboration, because Ramanujan's creativity and Hardy's technical skill both are used to the full extent to get this. Pn to be given by a nearest integer to a series S, which is rho, to be calculated within prescribed limits. The first six terms of the series for P100, the first six terms, as you see, the terms are becoming very, very small, and it is the integer part which you have to take. So P100 will be, according to them, is the nearest integer. That means it will be 292. And it is really so. P100 is really so. So they are obviously very excited about this result. And similar accuracy was observed for P equal to 200 also. And think of those are pre-computer days. So to get the exact value, they had to employ certain human calculators, just like our Shakuntala Devi, who can calculate very fast and accurate. They are not mathematicians. So similar accuracy for P equal to 200. But Ramanujan wanted an exact formula, not approximation. But he was discouraged by Hardy, because Hardy said previously Ramanujan claimed an exact result for pi n, the number of primes up to some number n. But Hardy showed that Ramanujan made a mistake. Actually, these results are known, but Ramanujan didn't know it. It was done in 1895 that, you cannot have pi n exact formula. You can only have an approximate formula. So Ramanujan agreed with Hardy that, okay, let us stop at this approximate result. But Ramanujan was correct, because only 20 years later, exact result was obtained by the German mathematician Rademacher. Only 20 years later. So this is one place where Ramanujan, who was normally very obstinate, gave in to Hardy's request that let us publish the approximate result rather than trying to get the final exact result. Well, Ramanujan's creativity and magical ways of producing new mathematical results sometimes attributed to his lack of formal mathematical education. Lots of people say that because he didn't know already established mathematics, he was not biased. He was very creative. He himself attributed it to the grace of their family deity, goddess Namagiri, which looked silly by most Westerners. They don't believe in this. But what they forget, that even other Western great mathematicians like Gauss, Pascal, Cantor, Littlewood also believed that inspiration had a divine aspect. Gauss, considered as the greatest mathematician, said he once proved a theorem not by dint of painful effort, but so to speak, by the grace of God.
Lecture. Now, I am very much astonished to know that how this calculation was going on when there was no computer. He is doing by his intuition, or like Shakuntala Devi, when some sum is given, she immediately gives the answer. It is coming from his mind or calculation, or what is the exact time? 6-7 figures is coming in Ramanujan's calculation. So it is a cubic fourth time. How he calculated it? In mentally, or by calculation in a sheet of paper, or it comes through his mind by intuition of the grace of God. What is the actual answer? We are astonished to have some answer.
True. I mean, are you talking of that continued fraction 1 by 6 or 300 or partition?
Cube. When the cubes are there, there are 6 figures are coming. Big figures of the results are coming.
Well, that's why Ramanujan only calculated few terms, you know. I gave two results. Those Ramanujan did with hand calculation, but it is only in 2004 somebody has come up with a formula for any n. And that can be checked by computer. That is
up to six figures
Ramanujan, because the problem was Ramanujan didn't even have money to buy papers. He used to do all his maths in slate and copy only the final result in his notebook to save paper. That's why it is still a mystery of certain of his results. Where are the details? The details have been erased on that slate.
So, thing is that he calculated himself what's coming from his mind.
Yes, something he calculated, but something always he said, like the calculated fraction, it flashed. He said, as soon as the problem was set, he thought it has to be a continued fraction, and this is the continued
fraction. After 70 years, the Shakuntala Devi is also being...
No, Shakuntala Devi is not a mathematician, sorry.
No, but the calculation results are...
No, that calculation there is always in the history. In Europe also, there are such human calculators, even during Gauss's time.
Please restrict your questions to one or two, because so many people are interested in asking questions. Let's just see if they come after the after release. Okay,
hello?
Yes.
I want to thank you many, many times for this very interesting lecture.
Thank you.
And brain, continuously brain is working in your lecture. And what I request you to have a paper, have your paper, copy of this paper, so that I can do it myself in house.
Well,
I want to have a copy of your paper.
Actually, I have written a book for school students, Popular Problems and Puzzles in Mathematics. There is, you know, some historically famous problems and theorems. There Ramanujan, Genius of Ramanujan is one section. There at least, not all, but most of these problems are both written and solved.
This time I may not be able to follow that book. I may not be, because brain is now going, my IQ is now going down.
Yes, but because it is a book, it is always in front of you. If you take the trouble of taking a piece of paper and pencil, I'm sure you'll be able to do it, because I myself am not a mathematician. Very difficult mathematics I neither understand nor follow. So whatever I know is really school level mathematics, and I'm sure in this crowd, everybody will be able to do that. Only a little patience is necessary.
What is the name?
Name of the book.
Name of the book is Popular Problems and Puzzles in Mathematics. It is the Cambridge University Press publication.
Sir, thank you very much.
Any computer specialist find any limitation in Ramanujan's theory and all these equations? Is there any limitation? Is there found?
No. Computer specialist has nothing to do with Ramanujan. Ramanujan was a mathematician. No, Ramanujan's mathematics, even Hardy found so many mistakes. Because Ramanujan didn't have formal training, as I said. For example, he didn't know complex analysis. He learned it only after reaching Cambridge. So Hardy proved that Ramanujan's result will be correct if there is no complex number. But because there is complex number, his results are wrong.
Next question.
Good evening, Professor. I would like to ask a question.
Yeah.
Are there any physical implications of this particular series and these particular geometrical forms and algebraic methods which Ramanujan created, physical implications used in physics and nonlinear dynamics fields like this?
Well, as I said, Ramanujan's mathematics was mainly number theory he concentrated, and number theory results are important in computer science, certain applications. Not physical applications, but computer science applications, there are a lot of applications to number theory.
But in continued fraction...
Those are all number theory.
Yeah.
Number theory has a lot of applications in computer science.
Mm-hmm. But in case of fractional mechanics or fractional dynamics, which is a part of nonlinear dynamics or fields like that,
okay,
where engineering is considered to be a greater extent of applications. In that fields, these are
applications. But as I said, I myself don't know of any application of number theory in engineering or physics. It's mostly in computer science.
One more question. Two more questions, please, and you can interact with him outside.
So what I would like to ask is, like that continued fraction you showed, the 6 was the, you know, the clue number. What is the, has it been proved generally that it is not possible for one or any other number but 6 only? So what about the general algebraic formulations of what Ramanujan and whatever flash prism is?
No.
Has that been done? And number two question is that, I mean, this is actually an extension of what he was asking. Regarding that, you know, that magic box, that magic matrix that you said, I mean, can't we use in cases of, you know, network theory and fluid dynamics and all these things? But these things are used by engineers.
Well, but as I said, I have not seen the computational fluid mechanics is a field, but particularly magic squares being used, I don't know of any application.
Okay, so the last question is, please, here. It was a spellbinding talk. I just would like to share a small comment. You had mentioned about Brahmagupta's solution of x square minus 92 y square equal to 1. And it just reminded me that last year, Manjul Bhargav was awarded Fields Medal, and he became famous for composition laws. And those composition laws are the generalizations of what Brahmagupta had done in order to solve that equation.
Yeah,
so I was just reminded of this.
But somehow, Manjul Gupta referred more to Gauss's work than to Brahmagupta's work.
But later
sure.
He didn't know about
he didn't know, but
later
on,
when he came to know, he has started.
Like, originally, when he wrote, he referred to a certain point as Gauss.
Actually,
rather
he came to know from one of my articles, and
yes.
Then he has been referring to Brahmagupta.
Yes. The same thing happened to me. I also wrote it at Pace equation. When one comment article reviewer brought my attention to Brahmagupta's equation, then only I read up Brahmagupta's equation and came to know that even Westerners are now calling it as Brahmagupta's equation.
We thank Professor Malik very much for this wonderful talk, very thought provoking. And maybe if you like to talk to him more, actually, we'll go out of this room. We can talk because what happens, the staff has to leave. So, must go outside of the room.